This is Dr. Lubna Fatima, senior lecturer from Department of Public Health Dentistry, and I'm here to indulge with the knowledge of history of fluorides. So in my presentation, I'm going to tell you from scratch what are the years involved in the history of fluoride, what are the authors involved, and what is the public health significance. So starting with in 1529, Georgius Agricola was the first person to introduce fluor spar as a flux. And later, after 360 years later, in 1886, Frederick Henry Moisan was the first person to isolate fluoride. So before the invention of fluoride in our oral cavity, the Frederick Henry Moisan isolated this element called fluorine. In 1901, Frederick McKay introduced Colorado stain, which is nothing but the mottled enamel where you can see white opaque opacities in your oral cavity. And in 1902, this became a public health issue, and Colorado Spring Dental Society took this as a lesion to investigate in the public. And in 1905, McKay again moved to Lawes to practice orthodontics. And in 1908, Odontological Society planned to perform camps where they were aware that this stain might become a very alarming significance to the public and it might go to the peak. So in 1909, McKay, Isaac Burton and Fleming together examined 2,945 children in public school of Colorado Spring, where he discovered 87.5% of the children's native to area had mottled enamel. So here, mottled enamel, they refer to the opacities in our oral cavity. So nearly in 100 people, 87.5% had fluoride. That is mottled enamel. And in 1912, McKay found article written by Dr. J.M. Eagle stating that brownish discolorization was seen in the oral cavity, which was stated as dentity chanting. And in 1916, McKay, along with G.B. Black, conducted nearly several studies in 26 communities to see this impact of, is this Colorado stain spreading or how are they getting? So he conducted several studies. So in 1918, followed by the several studies conducted by McKay, he confirmed that the main reason for this mottled enamel was the water supply, where the fluoride content in the water was higher than the optimal level, which caused this opaque opacity in our enamel called the mottled enamel. Then followed by in 1931, Churchill was the person who introduced that fluoride levels ranging from 13 to 17 ppm in Buside water. And in same year, remember 1931, shoe leather survey was conducted by Trendley H. Dean, where he isolated 22 cities in 10 states of USA on a total population of 5,824 children, that is 5,824 children. These may ask as a one word. So Churchill was the first person to identify fluoride level in the Brucite water, which ranged from 13 to 17 ppm. And then moving on to the mottling of enamel at various concentration of fluoride, we can see that the high concentration of the fluoride directly links with the severity of mottling seen in the enamel. So enamel mottling was seen by 3 ppm of fluoride itself, whereas mottling with discrete pitting was seen in 4 ppm of fluoride. So you have to know what is the optimal level of fluoride is 0.7 to 1.2 ppm of fluoride. So enamel mottling is seen in 3 ppm. Mottling with discrete is seen 4 ppm. Mottling was less and dull chalky white appearance was seen in 2.5 to 3 ppm. Whereas no mottling was seen in 1 ppm. So in this slide, you have to remember that the mottling was first appeared during 2.5 to 3 ppm itself. Then again, moving on to the history, in 1934, Dean Fluorosis Index was introduced, which was done to record the fluoride and gave a ordinal score of seven ordinal scores were given, ranging from no severity to very severe. And in 1942, they modified it into modified Dean Florence's index, where here the ordinal scale was 7 and they further made it as 6. And in 1942, one ppm of fluoride consumption found 60% reduction in fluoride. So we call fluoride as a double squad, where you have a good in it as well as a bad in it. So fluoride helps you to reduce dental caries, but at the same time, an optimal level is good, whereas higher than the optimal level can cause damage to the enamel tooth surface. In 1969, WHO advocated that 1 ppm of fluoride in community water supply was a practical and effective public health measure. Now, this is all about the history of fluoride. So remember always, the important fact in my presentation was Colorado stain, which was a very public health significant that time, which was the introduction of this motile enamel onto the tooth surface. So it was done in 1901 by McKay. And in 1931, Churchill was the first person to introduce the fluoride content in brewside water. And in 1931, shoe leather survey was conducted. And an index, you have to remember two indexes, Dean Florence's index and modified Dean Florence's index, where the years Dean Florence's index was introduced in 1934, whereas modified was given in the year 1942. Motling sign, 1 ppm, no motling was seen. In 2.5 to 3 ppm, motling was there, whereas dull white chalky appearance was seen. More than 2-3 ppm, enamel motling was seen. 4 ppm, motling with discrete pitting was seen. So I'll give you a recap by asking you some MCQs. Just see whether you remember things. So Colorado stain was introduced by Dean Churchill McKay Knudsen. So as we all know, Dean is the one who gave the fluoroses index, which was given in the year 1942, was the modified, and original was 1934. So eliminate that option. Churchill was the first person to isolate fluoride and find the 13 to 17 ppm was present in brewside water. So eliminate that also. McKay was the first person to discover the Colorado stain, which then become the public health significance. So the element fluoride was discovered by Churchill in the year 1931. Now, what is the other health significance of this 1931 is shoe leather survey, which was done by Trendley H. Dean. Remember that, okay? So the term motile enamel in Colorado stain was given by, who was the person who coined Colorado stain was? We all know it was McKay. So this is all about the history of fluoride. Mainly, while doing anything, try to mind map the topic after you study. So always when you mind map, the 1 hour which you study will give a collective things of what is really important in the 1 hour you studied. So always go with the flow. Public health significance, if you come, you always need to remember the year and what is the actual health significance related to that particular year. And for index, you need to remember what are the advantages, disadvantages, or indication, contraindication, and what is the ordinal scale present and how many it is present. In Motling sign, you have to particularly remember the ppm in which the change occur in the tooth. So make sure that this specific ppm might be very good for the tooth. So 0.7 to 1.2 ppm is very optimal level of fluoride, which doesn't cause any harm. Whereas more than that, so 2.5 was the first ppm which showed a change in the tooth surface, where motling was seen as a dull white chalky appearance. And these fluoride content in the tooth may be also categorized in the severe form, which is more than 8 ppm, into skeletal fluorosis, which is also a public health impact, which might cause very poor health significance onto the person who is affected. So mainly this fluoride was very good in optimal level, whereas higher the fluoride content, it causes harm to the tooth surface as well as systemic effects also. So this is all about history of fluorides. Thank you.